Premised on the rampant corruption in several government organs, Anti-Corruption Coalition Uganda has called for the creation of an international anti-corruption court that would prosecute those indicted in theft of public funds.
And one of the reasons as to why we feel that as a country we should petition or put our hand onto this petition is one, that in case the International Anti-Corruption Court is established, it will provide potential for more effective prosecution and punishment of corrupt officials who commonly abuse public resources, but in most cases end up going away scot-free, or because of selective prosecution, in most cases some of them will not be held accountable.
However, will the creation of this court succeed where the ICC fell short on impartially prosecuting criminal offenders?
Because we know that currently, much as we have the Whistleblowers Act, few people trust the police with their information. The same police, as we know, when you look at various reports, Transparency International reports, IGG report, the police has been one of those institutions that has been faulted in corruption. So people may not at times trust this information with giving it to the police. So we believe that if the International Anti-Corruption Court is being put in place, whistleblowers will feel more comfortable to come and give out information, which information the international investigators will use, like we see what happens under the ICC.
With the court's creation, civil society affirms that an alternative and suitable forum for the enforcement of laws that criminalize corruption worldwide will help stem the vice. However, government believes that protocol ought to be followed while instituting international statutes.
So there are two issues here. One is that individuals cannot institute, start the process of instituting an international court. It must be member states and their protocols and what have you. For instance, the protocol of the International Criminal Court, the African Court of Justice. The African Court of Justice, the protocol was adopted in 2003. It took 6 years for it to come into force. So it's not every day that individual private citizens or civil society organizations begin a process.
The minister maintains that Uganda is a sovereign state with well-established institutions capable of fighting corruption.
As far as we know, in Uganda, we have moved greatly in as far as the fight against corruption is concerned. From the situation where we had a backlog of corruption cases to now where we have a special division of the High Court strictly handling matters of corruption, and we have been many of them expedited and concluded. We have seen senior citizens in this country being taken to the anti-corruption court. We have seen ministers even stepping aside. That is unprecedented in the history of Uganda ever since we got independence.
In most cases, anti-corruption agencies mandated to fight corruption have opted to contend with political interferences when handling high-profile cases. This, they affirm, undermines the fight against corruption. The campaign to rally for an international anti-corruption court started in January with Judge Mark Wolf leading the pack of petitioners. Over 500 signatures are required to kickstart this campaign.